Assalamu alaikum. We know that the voltage induced in the coils placed on the rotor of a DC machine, that voltage is not a unidirectional voltage. The process to convert that voltage signal into a unidirectional voltage signal is called commutation. We have talked about the process of commutation for a simple loop rotating in a magnetic field. Over there, we had utilized a split ring arrangement to get a unidirectional voltage signal out of that loop. We also talked about the process of commutation in DC machines with the help of a four loop DC machine. Over there, we had an arrangement of commutators and brushes to get a unidirectional voltage out of the DC machine. There are certain problems associated with the process of commutation. The first important problem is the armature reaction, and the second problem associated with commutation in DC machines is LdIdt voltages. And in today's lecture, we shall talk about the first problem associated with commutation in real DC machines, that is, we shall talk about armature reaction. To understand the phenomena of armature reaction, let's consider a DC machine shown by the diagram over here. In here, we have a DC machine with north pole and south pole, and 8 conductors, 8 coils are shown on the rotor. The connection of these coils with commutator segments is not shown in this diagram. We know that when load is connected to this machine, current will start flowing in the coils. Load in the case of motor, we know that the same machine can work as both as a motor as well as a generator. The difference between a motor and generator is the speed of rotation of the rotor and direction of current in the coils. In case of motor, we have we connect an external power supply to this machine, and then current starts flowing in the coils through the commutator segments and brush arrangement, and that energy supplied by the external power supply gets converted into mechanical energy, and then that mechanical energy drives an external mechanical load connected to this machine. In the case of a generator, this rotor is connected with an external mechanical source which rotates it at higher speed, and then the conductors rotating in a magnetic field, voltage is induced in these coils, and then when this induced voltage, some external electrical load is connected to this generator, then current starts flowing in these coils to the load through commutator segments and brush arrangement. So when current flows in the conductors, there is a magnetic field produced around the these conductors. So let's assume some direction of current in these conductors. Due to this current, there will be a magnetic field around the conductors. The direction of that magnetic field can be determined by the grip rule. That is, if thumb indicates the direction of current, fingers will indicate the direction of magnetic field around the conductors. So let's show the magnetic field due to these conductors. So this magnetic field due to current in the coils will interact with the main magnetic field and will distort the original magnetic field. And due to the distortion in the original magnetic field, there are two effects. The first one is the neutral plane shift, and the second one is flux weakening. So let's first talk about neutral plane shift. When no current is flowing in the coils, that is when no load is connected to this machine, there is only magnetic field due to the main poles, and we already know that at this point the net flux density was equal to zero, so this plane is called neutral plane. So when no current is there in the coils, there is only magnetic field due to main poles, and flux density at this point is zero, and this is the plane which is the neutral plane. Let's now redraw this figure to show what will be the net magnetic field when we will have both the magnetic fields, that is the magnetic field due to the main coil, main magnets, and the magnetic field due to current in the coils. So here is the main magnetic field due to north and south pole. We know that these flux lines are always perpendicular to the surface of the rotor. So these are the flux lines. This is the magnetic field due to main poles, and the magnetic field due to these coils can be shown like this one. So here this is the magnetic field due to current in these coils. So what we can see is that in between these two conductors, at this point, the flux lines, the MMF due to this conductor and MMF due to this conductor, both are opposing, and at the outer side, both are supporting each other. So this is the net magnetic field due to these coils. And likewise, the magnetic field due to coils on this side is shown by this line. So what we see is that at this end of the north pole, the direction of the MMF due to the main poles, which is this one from the north pole to the south pole, and the direction of MMF due to current in these coils, that is also in the same direction. Whereas at this end, the direction of main magnetic field is from north pole to the south pole, whereas the direction of MMF due to current in the coils, that is in the opposite direction. So at this end, both the MMFs, that is the MMF due to main pole and MMF due to currents, both are in the same direction. Therefore, MMF at this end will increase, net MMF. Whereas at this end, the net MMF will decrease. The same situation over here. At this end of the north pole, the MMF due to main poles and MMF due to current in the coils are in opposite direction, and here these are in the same direction. So MMF at this end will decrease and MMF will at this end will increase. That situation, or that is the net MMF that will be there in the machine, that is depicted in this figure. At this end, MMF has increased, so we have more flux lines. Density, higher density of flux lines, and here we have MMF is decreased, so we have less density of flux lines. And here is the situation, MMF increased at this end and MMF decreased at this end. So this situation is as if we have moved the poles, the north pole and south pole, from this location to this location. The poles are still at the same position, however, the effect is as if we have move the poles to a new location, and hence the plane at which the flux density is zero, that also shifts. So the new neutral plane is over here, that is the plane at which flux density is zero has been shifted. So this is the new neutral plane. And this phenomena is called neutral plane shift. To summarize, due to current in the coils, there is a magnetic field, and the interaction of the main magnetic field and magnetic field due to the coils, current in the coils, due to that interaction, the neutral plane shifts by some angle. That phenomena is called neutral plane shift. And the shift in the neutral plane is opposite for the case of generators and for the case of motors, because the direction of flow of current is opposite in the conductors. If this is the situation of a motor, and in the case of generator, the neutral plane shift will be towards right in clockwise direction. What is drawback of this neutral plane shift? To understand the drawback, let's again consider the situation of commutation in the case of for loop machine that we have already talked about. This is the figure that we have already talked about when we were discussing commutation in for loop DC machine. Brushes were located at this position, and corresponding to this situation, we have drawn a diagram which is shown over here. Corresponding to this time instant, we had drawn this diagram, and since these conductors were beyond the pole faces, no voltage was being induced in these conductors, whereas voltage E was being induced in these conductors. We have brushes at this location. And now each conductor behaves as a voltage source. What we see is that the two ends of the voltage source are being shorted through these brushes. This end is connected to this commutator segment, this end is connected to this commutator segment, and this brush is connected in contact with both the segments. Two ends of this voltage source are being shorted. However, fortunately, there is no voltage induced, so the voltage source that is being shorted has 0 volts. So that was not a problem, because neutral plane was here. No voltage was being induced, and even if two ends of this voltage source are being shorted, that is not a problematic. However, when neutral plane shifts due to this effect, what will be the situation? Here is new neutral plane, and now this pole, this conductor is under the influence of this pole. Likewise, this conductor is under the influence of this pole because neutral plane has shifted. Now this is the plane at which flux density is zero, and hence some voltage will be being induced in this coil. And now two ends of the the voltage source, if shorted, that will result into problem. So that is the first problem of neutral plane shift. Due to neutral plane shift, the voltage which we were assuming that no voltage is being induced in this coil, and that is why the two ends of this coil were being shorted. Now some voltage is being induced in these coils, and we cannot short them. So this is one problem associated with armature reaction, that is neutral plane shift. What are the solutions to that? We shall talk about that in the later lecture. Now let's talk about the second problem of flux weakening. What we see is that MMF at this end has increased and MMF at this end has decreased. So the net MMF is almost still the same, because the decrease over here is equal to increase over here. So net MMF is still the same. What about flux? Let's see the magnetization curve of ferromagnetic materials. Here we have on this axis we have MMF, and here we have flux, and the magnetization curve relates the two quantities. Machines are generally designed to work at the knee of the curve, and this gives you maximum flux corresponding to MMF. So at this end we have decreased the MMF, so at this end flux has been decreased, and at the other end of the pole MMF has increased by the same amount. This is decrease, and by the same amount here is increase. However, what we observe is that the decrease in flux is more compared to increase in the flux at this end. Although net MMF here, decrease in MMF, increase in MMF is almost the same as decrease in MMF over here. However, due to the saturation in this curve, the flux, decrease in flux over here is much more than in increase in flux over here, and the net flux in the machine will decrease, and this effect is called flux weakening. So these are the problems associated with armature reaction, and in the next lecture we shall talk about this problem, which is there in the commutation of real DC machines, and then later on we shall talk about solutions to these problems.